Welcome to this week's White House History Weekly. We have a very interesting insight for you today into first ladies who were artists and musicians. Sarah Fling, who is our American University Fellow in our David M. Rubenstein National Center for White House History, will share these interesting insights with us.
Thank you, Stuart. America's first ladies have long been tied to the arts, often through philanthropy undertaken while living at the White House. But did you know that some first ladies were artists themselves? First Lady Caroline Harrison, for example, was a passionate watercolorist. Mrs. Harrison studied art and music in school and later took painting lessons in Indianapolis, Indiana. In her Indiana home, she gave her own lessons and established an art studio. She also shared her work in local exhibitions. When the Harrisons moved into the White House in 1889, she continued her art lessons and invited congressional and cabinet wives to join her at the White House. Mrs. Harrison loved watercolors, china painting, and florals. She even helped to design the Harrison China Service. She was so passionate about art that she proposed the addition of a new wing on the White House to house an art gallery, but it never came to fruition. Meanwhile, First Lady Ellen Wilson was a professional artist who painted in the Impressionist style. Mrs. Wilson attended art school in Georgia and later in New York City. As a teenager, she exhibited her art internationally at the Paris International Exposition, where she won a prize for drawing. She later exhibited her artworks a number of times, including one-woman shows, and lived in artist colonies in the American Northeast. After her husband, Woodrow Wilson, was inaugurated in 1913, she set up an art studio in the White House and continued to sell her paintings. As First Lady, she didn't claim the profits and instead donated the money to the Martha Barry School for Underprivileged Girls, which was in her hometown of Rome, Georgia. A number of First Ladies were also talented musicians. Louisa Catherine Adams became First Lady in 1825 and made music a key facet of her time in the White House. Mrs. Adams was an accomplished harpist, and she often entertained guests with music that she had composed herself. She took solace in her music, preferring solitude and peace to the hustle and bustle of the executive mansion. First Lady Helen Taft was an especially accomplished pianist who called music the absorbing interest of my life, the inspiration of all my dreams and ambitions. In her home state of Ohio, Mrs. Taft helped to found the Cincinnati Symphony Orchestra. She later brought her love of music to the White House in 1909 and transformed the famous Blue Room into a personal music room. She practiced piano there frequently. Whether through participation or patronage, America's First Ladies are key supporters of creativity. Thanks to them, the White House has long been a bastion of arts and culture, where musicians and artists are celebrated and welcomed for their contributions to American society.